Okay, boys and girls, back here in the ski shop again today. And what we're going to do is, I did make a video. It's like the world's longest ski tuning video for park tuning. And that entailed a lot of work. But I want to show you guys today what is the one most important thing to do if you have a ski that you're going to ride on boxes, rails, and tubes. Okay, you're riding the steel. Okay, so let's take a look at this new ski just for kicks anyway. Try to get the right angle here. Take a look at the edge. Okay. Now you see that change there? Don't know. It's our okay, there's a change right here. Okay, so right here the machine is tuning the ski at the factory and it's whirling around. It's a little disc, and when it gets to the edge end of the ski where the ski tips down right there, see, look right there where it tips down, that comes off the ski. So all this edge where it tips up has never been really touched at all, and that's not that big of a deal out at the tip of the tail, but you still want to bring that base bevel even the whole way. So what we're going to talk about today is this. The single most important thing to do to your park ski before you start riding rails on them. Okay, now we're going to follow this edge, come down here, and we'll see the same thing when we get to this end of this thing. Okay, right where my thumb is, that's where the change is. I don't know, I can't see the dang light. Anyway, that's where she changes, where the wheel comes off. So the main thing is, it's a long base bevel, guys. It's what I call a long base bevel. And I tried to draw this picture, and I'm not very good drawing here at trying to explain what I'm trying to say. Let's see if I can put this thing up somewhere where we can see it more better. Let's see here. Okay, so let's say this one on the top. Let's just say this is the way the ski's coming. So this would be the base of the ski, this flat part, and then this angled part, that would be the metal edges. Okay, well, right there where the metal edges and the plastic connect, that is well, you're gonna catch a lot, okay? So what we want to do is we want to file these two little edges down to where they actually come into the plastic. So again, not a very good at drawing, but so what we want to do is file this thing down on an angle until between there and there is where the plastic is. So we're gonna file down the metal edge until we come all the way into the plastic, and then that creates a base high ski. So you don't need to round your edges off when you do it like this. You can still pull a carve when you tip the ski up enough anyway. You're gonna have to tip it up, but then you're not dull. You don't have to dull your edges out. Now, if you are doing a lot of crossing of the skis, when you're in the air and you're having problems with top sheets and whatnot, then what you do is you go, like, let's say this is your problem area right in front of the binding. You're always, marring your top sheets up and cutting them up because you're crossing your skis and this is hitting. Then just in front of the binding, you can round that off a little bit. And you can just do that with a gumi stone or whatever. You don't need to take a file and gnarlate it. But the other thing that's important in that aspect, when you look at a ski like this has got a sidewall and a top sheet that stops it anyway. So now let's say you were crossing your skis a lot, so you rounded this off a little bit so it's not so sharp. Then you'd take this section of top sheet where you're crossing your skis and you'd round this off, because actually there's almost like a little lip right here. Okay. And when the sharp edge hits this, I mean, it's going to start cutting it up and that could delam it. So you take a file, you know, a real coarse file, and you round all this off. I don't know if I'm going to do that. I don't know if Charlie's doing a lot of ski crossing, but when he's in the air. But at any rate, so, okay, I'm already going too deep. I'm going to show you guys that one step. I call it a long base bevel. So what we're going to do is we're going to base bevel these skis until... We're going to base bevel these edges this way and this way. I mean, that's what base bevels are. You can't add steel to make them go up. Anyway, we're going to base bevel these till the base bevel extends into the plastic at least about the same width as the metal edge. Okay, and we want to see that plastic being affected all that distance. And then that's going to give us this long base bevel. And so when you jump up and land on a rail or a tube, you're not getting drag off the edges. I mean, yeah, when you really tip your ski, you're going to hit the edge. But the main thing is, anyway, that's what we're going to do, a long base bevel. And that's the most important thing. So let's just take a good look at one of these right now. And then after we work on it, we'll look at it again, okay? And hopefully you'll be able to see a difference. Now, basically it's on the black part of the base is where you can really see the difference on a ski. When you get into this colored stuff, you're not going to notice as much. So take a look here. In all this part, we should be able to see the difference. So, all right, there it is. Now we'll have to get to work. Okay, so I got this file. This is a pretty coarse file right here. Now you could get a coarser one, and this is really not even that great of a file, so I may have a hard time getting into some of the hardened edge when they file these things at the factory with those wheels. It gets them pretty hard. I may just try to use this lower portion of the file where it's not so used. But if we can get it to cut, we could just start with this one right here. Doing a little extra at the tip because that's where it's never been beveled over from the factory. You start getting debris, you need to stop, pull the debris out. Got a pretty decent bevel in it here. Definitely is changing. Not getting much material there. The plastic edge is... Plastic is hard to file. I mean, you gotta have a pretty coarse file to start pulling that. Now I'm getting to where the machine came off. And we're getting quite a bit right there. And there you can see the results when you're really getting the filings. So, this is not really an easy job to do because you gotta get into that plastic. And metal files real good, but plastic don't file that good. So we'll just give it another couple passes with this. See if we can break through the layer of hardened steel from that factory wheel. And it feels like we definitely are, because you see the debris that I got now, see, from coming down the middle of the ski, whereas we weren't really getting that before. So we broke through the hard layer. Now we're getting to that tail where tips and tails, where you saw that, where the wheel comes off. Those are basically no base bevel at the tip and tail. And if you're going to do some butters and stuff and get up on those tips, you're better off to have that bevel run all the way up to that tip and whatnot. So don't neglect that tip and that tail. And on that note, come up here and work this tip a little bit more to where I feel like it's blending in with the rest of it. That feels a little better. Okay. Not bad. These bases on these vocals, that's pretty hard. Pretty hard. There's different hardnesses of plastic too. And the harder plastics can, well, I think plastic's hard to file. The harder plastics are even harder. So, anyway, look what we got off there so far. See? So even if that was all I did, that would be way better than nothing. But we want to get into that. We want to bevel it until we can see it affecting the plastic. Okay? And I'm using a 1 degree base bevel. You generally don't need to go into a 2 degree base bevel to do this. Yeah, 2 degree base bevel will make your edge sharper this way, and that will lift it up off the snow some more. But if you don't get in and affect the plastic, you're not in and up with what you want. So just for kicks, I got this other file that's coarser, but I think it's so dull. I don't know. But if I got any sharpness left in this one, you see, she's really coarse. But she's been abused from doing a lot of sidewall stuff, so I don't know. Maybe I should have got a file to demonstrate this, but we're going to try with this file that's even coarser and see if I can get it to cut. She's cutting, but not very strongly. So she's a little dull for sure. Yeah, she's a little dull. She's cutting, but not much. So that's not going to work. That's not going to work. To get into this plastic, you need a really coarse file for sure. And there's another style of file that a guy can use, but I don't have a piece of it long enough to put into this tool. And that's a pansar file like this. Now you can get these pansars in big, dang it. You can get these in a big long section, but I don't have a big long section of this. But these you can really, I mean, boy, you could do some damage though if you don't know what you're doing. But these will cut that plastic back a lot easier than what I'm using. So, anyway, blah, 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 blah. Let's just keep working it with what I got. Then we'll get in there with the finer ski file too. So here's the finer ski file that's got some sharpness left to it. Ah, well, heck, let's give this one a couple twirls and see how it gets into the plastic. Because this one's sharp, I know that, but it's not coarse. Yeah, this is some tough plastic here. Oh, we're getting good edge here, though. That's good. He's working it. Look at that, look at that, look at that, look at that. See, that's what you want. Just want to keep working that puppy. Not an easy job all the time. Depending on, again, what kind of file you got. And you know, when you like right there, see, nothing's happening because that's the file just basically running on the plastic, which it doesn't like to cut. And now we're cutting edge again real good, which shows you how uneven the base bevel is on these factory skis, see? See, not getting anything. And then, now I'm getting it again, see? Now I'm getting edge again. There we go. Oh yeah. So anyway, you continue this process. Keep beveling and beveling this until you get to the point where you see it's really affected the plastic. And I'm not gonna lie, I'm having a hard time on this one, so. But I got four edges to do, so we'll cut and we'll come back, we'll work on these, and we'll see if we can show you a better result. But that's the idea. Holy moly, this has not been easy. So let's see if you can see the affection next to the edge where the plastic has gotten into a little bit. See? Now, this is super typical in a lot of skis from the factory. This edge here was not beveled as much. This edge over here was beveled much steeper. So when I first started working on this side, all I hit was the very edge of the metal next to the P-Tex. And anyway, let's see if we can get some different angle. And we finally got it. You can't see it as much in this part, but see if we could see this here where it's black again. Now look closely where the plastic has been affected by the file that's going on an angle like this. Okay. So there it is. Now I'm going to come back with a wet diamond stone and I'm going to work the crap out of this again. But yeah, not easy work all the time for sure. But see, look at again, that edge where you keep filing that thing till you see it affecting that plastic. And again, this is only a 1 degree. And it usually works pretty good. But anyway, yeah, this edge, yeah, and this edge, yeah, they're totally different. So as I'm doing this, I'm actually straightening the bevels out better so that they're more the same on each side of the ski. So there it is. Stand by, and, well, I'll show you some more again later. Oh, my God. Okay, I worked both those things over hard. And the other ski was just the same as the first one. The one side was beveled way more than the other side. So I really couldn't even get the factory out completely of the other side. Because it was just so much more beveled, you know, like maybe closer to a 2 degree bevel than a 1 degree bevel. And the other side of the ski was more like a 1 degree bevel. So before I start the wet work with the diamond stone, I got to vacuum all this up and clean it up. But so this is the swore for the, you know, the metal filings that I got off, okay? And I don't know, these Vocal skis, man, I think they got some really hard edges. And the base plastic is really hard, too. If I had my way, I'd go downtown, which is a long ways from me, and get a Pansar file, long one of those. And that would have made it a little easier. I probably could have got into the plastic more. But we got some pretty good affection. And we got them beveled down much nicer now. So I'll do the wet work. We'll show you a little bit of the wet work. And then we'll show you the end end. So I'll just show you a little of the wet work, how that goes. Because that's an important final step. Okay? Okay, audio. Okay, now we're going to get into the finishing. All that work on the edges, I did finish off with the finer file, but these are, you know, they're rough from the filing, a lot of striation. Anyway, the last step is we're going to polish these down. The smoother and more polished they are, the better they'll slide on the rails and boxes. So what we're going to use first is a 100 diamond stone. So 100 grit, this one's a Moonflex, you can get them in plenty of different brands and stuff. So I'm going to do a 100, around with 100, and then I'm going to do a round with the 200, okay? You're not going to see much difference in these, but the red one, that's your 200, the black one, that's your 100. So this will remove a little more material, not like a file, but it'll remove and smooth them out, make them really polished. Now, whenever you're doing your diamond stones, you always want to use a mixture of water and alcohol, preferably denatured alcohol. Now, this is denatured alcohol right here, okay? So you can get this at most hardware stores, okay? Or I don't know, maybe in some places they're not letting you have it anymore. I've read about that because they don't want you using this for camp fuel. Anyway, if you can't get this, you can use regular, you know, 95% rubbing alcohol, I guess, if that's all you got. But it doesn't have to be 50-50 in the water, but you know, you want to, they recommend 50-50 water and 50-50 denatured alcohol, but you want at least like 25% of this, like 25% of the alcohol and 75% water at least. And what that does is the alcohol removes the surface tension in the water. Okay, and when you remove that surface tension, it makes it everything go better. Okay, and at any rate, as you do this, you know, because you got a long bevel, you're going to be working into that plastic, and that clogs the stones up. The fluid always helps keep the stones cleaner. Okay. And so you want to use that fluid all the time. And then you're going to use a brush to come back and brush those stones out. So this is the way I do it. You take your 100 and dip the whole thing in the water, okay? Start giving it a few mild strokes. Dip it in the water again. You cannot use too much fluid when you're doing this, okay? And it gets messy. Yeah, it's a lot of fluid, but just make sure you got plenty of fluid. And you'll hear it starts smoothing out. But because I'm trying to do a long bevel on this, I'm going to work these over pretty good for a while. So I might do this for, I don't know, 4 or 5 minutes per edge on each stone. So I'm not going to bore you guys to death, okay? But that's what you do, okay? And you can hear it, like up here, working harder. You don't want to press too hard with the diamond stones. You want to get pressure, but let the stone do the work, you know? Especially if you got a bird old ski. Anyway, yeah. Just let the stone do the work. Plenty of fluid. Plenty of fluid. Okay, so anyway, we're going to do that with the 100 a while. Then we're going to go to the 200, and we're going to do that on all the edges of both skis. And then I will show them to you at the end. And hopefully in the proper light, we'll be able to see sort of the effect we did. And anyway, yeah, both these skis were the same. So on this ski, this angle was, you know, yay much. And on this side of the ski, the angle was way sharper. So that's real common. You get a new ski like this and you turn one way and the ski seems to turn right away and turn easier. And then you go to turn the other way and it's like, what the hell is going on? Well, unfortunately, that's the way of the world nowadays. Now, FIS race skis, they don't come tuned at all. They grind it out and they make it flat. And it's up to the technician to create the angles. So, but on consumer skis, it's not that way. Now, one day you might get lucky. Maybe each edge will be pretty equivalent. But a lot of times, you know, that base bevel's all warbly and crappy. And one edge may be way more than the other. So, you know, that's life. What do? You just try to equal it out as much as you can. Because this one had a lot more bevel, I just tried to get it to affect the edge here as much as I could, you know, to get it looking kind of like this one. Anyway, blah, 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 blah. So, there it is. You just keep polishing those, all four base edges. When you're done doing all that, you're going to have a little burr on the side. So what you can do is, well, there's a couple different ways you could do it. You could take a gumi stone, or you could just take your 200, you know, once you're all done doing it this way, and just come back like this on the side edge. A little bit like this, you know, keep her wet all the time. And then that kind of pull that burr off that edge. And then you come back again. Pulling those burrs, you can just do it by hand, you know, because you're just going to that very edge, okay? So that would be your finishing, final finishing, okay? All right, we'll catch you when I'm done doing all this, and we'll try to take a good look and see if we can see the difference from the beginning when I started this. Okay, I'm using a lot of fluid, so I'm not really getting a lot of clog from the plastic, and this can be hard to see because it's wet, you know, and whatnot. You really want to use a lot of fluid, but right in here, there's a little blackness, and that's where that plastic is getting embedded in there. And as that plastic builds up in the stone itself, it's going to prevent it from cutting as well. So what you do is you take it and you dunk it in the bucket. And you scrub it, you dunk it in the bucket, and you scrub it with your brush. You dunk it in the bucket, and you scrub it with the brush, okay? And then now once you're done doing that, Now you get a pretty doggone clean stone again, okay? Now you're ready to come back and continue your work. Now, anyway, that's the deal. So, a lot of fluid, but even with the fluid, after you've been doing this a while, if you see where you're working the stone, you can move the stone back and forth in the guide, you know, to get a fresh position. But if you see it all building up with black plat, you know, stop, clean it out, then keep working. You'll work a lot less hard that way, because once it clogs up with that plastic, you're not going to be cutting much, okay? Well, okay, so here's the last little bit of finishing on the edges, okay? So I'm just going to use the 200, that's the finer stone. And what we want to do here is, let's say the angle's like this much, anyway, we just want to tilt it a little bit extra. Because we just want to be right on that very, very edge, you know, where the sharpness is. So first thing, though, you do is this edge on a ski is tuned with a little bit of angle this way, okay? And so we just want to kind of hold it like that, pretty vertically on the edge. And then this way, the ski is tuned this way, and we just want to tip it a little bit more. And you listen, and you just try to... You'll hear the roughness. I'm not pressing hard at this step at all, okay? No hard pressing here, just barely touching it and listening. Just until she kind of smooths out. Listen and do not press hard here. I'm basically holding it vertically. Okay, that's feeling pretty good now. Now I'm going to go for this edge here again, and I can hear it. It's a little clickety-clankety. Don't press too hard now. Just let the stone do the work, and you'll hear it smooth up. Might take a little bit. You're not trying to take the sharpness off the edge. You want the sharpness. You're just doing that last little bit of deburring that final edge. And you know, you guys aren't freaking racing World Cup. You're riding rails, but you still, you know, what you're going to get out of it is what you put into it. You want to do all this work. You want to do this long base bevel when the ski's new, before you start riding rails, okay? Once you start riding rails, you're going to be pounding this thing. Of course, now, the smoother you are getting onto a rail or a tube, yeah, the better off your ski's going to be if you're smooth. But when you're pounding, the metal gets what's called work hardened. And once you work hard in it, it's hard as a whore's heart. And it's very difficult to do this kind of work, let alone even hitting it with the file. Okay? So, yeah, there's a little bit work involved here in doing this long base bevel. But, again, lifts those edges a little bit higher. Gives you a more base high ski. Are your edges going to crack eventually? Sure. Especially if you're not a real smooth, you know, if you're not real smooth getting on. You know, if you do a disaster and you come down with, you know, 5,000 pounds of force on the end of the rail or the box and just slam that puppy, yeah. Well, you know, the smoother you are getting on, even if it's a disaster, the longer your edges are going to last. And doing this long base bevel, even if you come back after this, you try the skis out a little bit, and you go, oh, well, I don't know, man, I think I... Okay, go ahead and take your damn file and round it a little bit more under the foot. But this is the first thing you're going to do. And 9 times out of 10, if you're any skier worth your weight in anything, this long base bevel, that's gonna do the trick. That's all you need to do. You'll still have a sharp edge when you want to cut a carve. Like now you just got off the rails and you want to cut a carve to up the jump ramp to get a really nice carve into the jump to do a really awesome fucking cork, you know, fucking, I should have said, if you want to do those, you know, those awesome cork, you know, triple spins and all that shit, you want to have some edge, you know. So, if you round your edges all off, you're just, you know, unless the snow's soft as crap, and even then you're just not, you know, performance is not going to be there. Now, you don't do this long base bevel for a pipe ski, okay? Yeah, if your specialty is pipe only, that's a whole different ball game, boys and girls. If you're setting up a ski for pipe, you set that puppy up for World Cup, man. Like a half degree base bevel only. And really, really sharp edges. But you are not going to get a consumer ski with a half degree base bevel without having it base ground blanked out to get it down to base bevel flat. You know, and then coming back and putting a half degree on it. Okay. That's why I wish they'd make all skis or like you could order a ski with no factory tune on it at all. Thing would be, you know, just ground flat and then up to you. But anyway, you know, they don't do it. Okay, so I'm going to pull the camera up the tripod. We'll take a look here and see if we can see that affection. And this is what you do. Okay. Stand by. Okay, so here's your result. And for one thing, if you look real close, it's kind of hard to tell, but there was that spot where when the wheel came off the ski that you could see a big divot. See, and now it's all smooth all the way through. Now look closely at the edges of the plastic where it meets the steel. You see how you can see the effect, and it's wider than the edge. It's only a half a degree though, so it's not a lot. Okay, now like I say, once you get into the colored areas you can't see it as much, but it is there. It's there, and this is especially important, you know, obviously riding boxes and rails under the foot. But the best thing is you want it pretty consistent tip to tail regardless. So now when we get back into the black, back in black, see how you see that affection from that base bevel, from filing it at an angle in this direction until we come all the way up into that plastic. Okay, so that's it boys and girls. That's your long base bevel, and that is how you do it, and that is what you want to do to the ski before you ever hit your first box or your first rail. Okay, this is the end now. Okay, so this is the other ski. We're looking for the affection of the plastic on the long base bevel, and we can see that. A little harder to see on the colored stuff, but you see it. It is there. Really important underfoot to have a good affection of that long base bevel. So any rate, there's one thing that I didn't say, and it probably should be pretty obvious. Let's get here to the black end. The black end, you know, once you go black, you know, anyway, yeah, black is always the best base. You got the carbon in there, less static. Anyway, one thing about doing a long base bevel, boys and girls, makes that ski, and like I said, probably should go without saying, but makes the ski way more playful, way easier and better to do, like surface spins, butters, and just, you know, just in general sliding. Now, when you want it to carve, just tip it up on the edge a little steeper, and you get your dang carve, okay? All right. So there it is. Do this again, before you ever hit a rail one, catch me a wild gun.